specialisms in, for instance, infectious diseases, materials, chemistry, and performance computing. So Liverpool City Region now finds itself in the unprecedented position, it has to be said, when it comes to new funding opportunities because of the specialisms we excel in. As you can see, I've put a simplistic chart up of when I became the portfolio holder, I asked how my portfolio totally looked. So it's fairly self-explanatory, I'm sure there's no questions on that. But since May 17, we've seen the CA invest hugely, has to be said, in making a difference, and we've supported projects such as Cllr and the Centre for Infectious Diseases. We're not just talking about these things anymore, we are putting our money where our mouth is. We've seen funding from different funding streams for the Materials Innovation Factory, the Centre City. The Hartree Centre has also relocated to better facilities, allowing them to expand on the great work they've done so far. And we're very proud of the direction our universities are heading in with regard to digital and innovation. Some of their schemes, which have been part-funded by us, are really putting our region on the map, and it's great that they're hitting so well with some of the digital connectivity that we want to push forward. These have recognised our Cllr 4.0 as an exemplar, and in fact, Greg Clark saw for himself the remarkable things that are happening in the city region when he visited in October. And I think he's really buoyed, genuinely buoyed by what we can do on behalf of not just Liverpool City Region of the North West, but the whole UK PLC. We launched a £5 million programme looking at advances in cognitive, like in high performance and cloud computing. We've hosted the City Region's first ever digital summit in October, which was very well received, and was when I went into virtual reality with a NASA scientist, very strange. But all of this proves that connectivity is absolutely vital for us as a city region, for all of us. If we link up those two great assets that I was talking about before with the supercomputer and the fiber optic cable, that will be transformational for our future prospects. So what does the future look like? Well, it's sure we want to use those assets to go from the city that was the gateway to the first industrial revolution to become the city region that is the digital gateway to the fourth industrial revolution. It's vital that we get better commercialisation, therefore, of the D in R&D. You know, we do very well sometimes, but we previously, it's been one of our weaknesses in our honesty, we don't just turn that into power up to our city region, but not just here, I think it's across the whole country that we need to improve that. We're trying to create an ecosystem, not just to incubate startup companies, but to allow them to grow and expand, so that they can build on the successes of things like, for instance, the Baltic Triangle and then other schemes on the Wirral and Knowsley, at least, who are doing similar sorts of things. But our future is really bright, and we need to take advantage of the specialisms we have in the likes of materials chemistry, infectious diseases, high performance and cognitive computing, AI and VR, and the assets that we have on our doorstep, as well as scaling up health and life science research, for instance, the stuff that is happening in Paddington is just exciting, not just for our area, but for the whole country. But to ensure that we do have that bright future that we all want, and it's our responsibility to create, we've got to build capacity so that we can bid in for a national pot of money. We have to market better what we excel at, and keep our light under our bushel far too much when compared to, say, to other command authorities. Next year is about translating all of the ambitions into investable propositions, which is why I'm particularly excited about the appointment of our Director of Commercial Investments, who's come in and will be tasked with that on day one. We have to secure revenue funding, of course, and that means working with the government of the day, and that's exactly what we're doing literally on a daily basis. We are pushing them to see whether we can get access to national pots of money. And we're going to be developing our local industrial strategy, and that will be a million miles away from the national industrial strategy, but it needs to work in tandem, teasing out our specialisms for the priorities in our area. So while there will be developments this year such as the stuff that's happening in Paddington, Knowledge Court and elsewhere. There are also many smaller important things that are happening too. So we need to encourage more people into like STEM to get involved in these innovative occupations of the future. So we want to introduce a city region-wide digital robot wars competition, which will see the best of our digital brains from across the six districts competing against each other, hopefully the arena or somewhere like that. And as we're scaling up our existing industry-led initiatives, we'll be updating the digital and creative sector on the findings of our skills for growth analysis, which is currently being undertaken. And we'll be looking to source funding to deliver the O2-led digital inclusion trailblazer, building on the success of the pilot which took place in St. Helens. Again, a fantastic thing that happened there, resulted in the town climbing 20 places on the digital index of connected towns. So we'll be seeking to do a number of things to scale up our LCR 4.0 initiative as a national programme, once again putting our city region on the map. We'll be better coordinating and improving our approach to the ongoing developments in the creative and digital sectors. It's no good any of us just sitting back and admiring the things we've done so well to date. We must be looking to improve at every opportunity. This is like a fast-moving feast. But we also will be hosting a series of sectoral roundtables with something called Facility Live, and they are facilitated both by the CA and the LEP. Facility Live is an Italian